Our next story is one you should give a hoot about. Minnesota is known for its wildlife. Well, here in Rochester, people spent the day gathering to get a glimpse of some great horned owls, but experts say you need to be mindful of what you're doing so you don't disturb them. Our Devin Martin shares what experts say you should do instead.
We all want to see the great horned owls here in northwestern Rochester. It's something to do during the pandemic, but experts say that if you do want to go see them, it's recommended that you stay here in your car.
And you could look out the window easily to look and see the nest.
Owls are a group of species that people love, but we can love them too much to their detriment. So because we don't often get to see them, people get very excited when there are opportunities like this.
Carla's right. Look at all these people that lined up to get pictures and videos of the great horned owls.
And it's easy, if you're unaware, to do things that are have negative impacts on the owls.
You can see here the mama bird and her babies. Things are normal, but things can disturb the owls quickly if people interrupt their space. The International Owl Center in Houston, Minnesota has a guide about how to respectfully photograph and observe owls. It says things you should do is to give owls their space, like these people are here, and to let owls find their own food. Flying drones near them is also dangerous.
Some things that people aren't aware of is owls are generally afraid of dogs. So if you are going to go, leave your dog at home. Given a week or two, those young ones are going to start branching and fledging, and very often they wind up on the ground. And it's all too easy, and I've seen it happen, where a dog runs in and attacks and kills a young one on the ground.
Carla says when photographing owls, if they're ignoring you, it's a compliment. Especially when they're sleeping, that's when you'll get the best photos. But they're stressed when they have a wide-eyed look, and they're in a defense stance, as seen here.
Every owl and every situation are unique. You can't have fixed guidelines that say you must be this far away, or you can't do this, or you must do that.
Take a look at this owl. This was sent from somebody else in Rochester. So if you see an owl, be mindful and respectful.
You're looking at a mama owl's nursery room. How would you like to have lots of people looking into your nursery room, you know, and making a lot of noise? Anything you could do that disturbs them is taking away energy that she should have for raising her young.
In Rochester, Devin Martin, ABC 6 News.
Very fascinating creatures there. Thank you, Devin, for that story. For a list of how to take pictures of those owls and observe them respectfully, we do have a link on our website, kaltv.com, under the Featured Links tab.